Bam! This is true. Well, in the next couple of videos, we're going to take our skills of factoring, now our reviewed skills of finding common denominators and adding and subtracting fractions or rational expressions, and start solving some equations. In this video, we're going to be dealing with just fractional coefficients, actually fairly straightforward. Then we're going to move in a couple of word problems that deal with the same or have the same design in their algebraic equation, but they're word problems. And then do another video where we have some algebraic expressions in both the numerator and denominator of the fractions. And that's really where you have to start needing to use all of those algebra skills we've been learning in the last few videos about adding and subtracting and multiplying algebraic fractions. What we're going to do with our rational equations or inequalities, one of these examples are going to be an inequality, is simply try and get rid of the fractions as fast as possible. And that means multiplying by the LCM, lowest common multiple, to get rid of the fractions as quickly as possible to, you know, simplify the problems. So we have a denominator here of 15, 15, and 6. I can deal with those all the way through the problem, or I can multiply both sides of the equation by something that will cancel out those denominators, the LCM. What number does 15 and 6 both go into? You can do prime factorizations and break it down like that, but hopefully at this point we can just, knowing our multiplication tables quite well, get, 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 15 goes into 30. So we're going to multiply both sides of this equation by 30. And on this first problem, I'm going to show this before we actually do any cancellation. I'll show all the multiplication just so you can see it, but you could probably do this in your head as well. We're going to have positive 30 times 4x squared over 15 equals positive 30 times negative 11 over 15x, and a positive 30, which is what we're multiplying by, I'm going to take care of this negative right now, times negative 1/6. Okay, well, 30 divided by 15 is equal to 2. 30 divided by 15 is again equal to 2. And 30 divided by 6 is equal to 5. So now that we've canceled out all those denominators, we can, you know, handle the rest of this problem, hopefully like with using the skills you've just learned in some past sections. We have 2 times 4, which is 8x squared. We have 2 times negative 11, which is negative 22x. And we have 5 times negative 1, which is negative 5. We're going to get everything over to one side of the equation because it's a quadratic. We have a term with a degree of 2 and a term with a degree of 1. So we're not just going to get x by itself. That's not going to be possible. With these quadratics where you have the setup where you cannot just get nx or ax alone, you have to set the equation equal to 0 and solve it by factoring into the quadratic equation or something. Let's see what we can do. We are going to move the negative 22 over with addition every time we go from one side of the equal sign or inequality sign to the other. We must do the opposite math operation. So we're going to add both sides by 22x, add both sides by 5, and get 8x squared plus 22x plus 5 is equal to 0. Now that leading coefficient is quite a bit larger than 1, and that means that we're not going to necessarily be able to easily factor this quadratic trinomial. So we can solve this using the quadratic formula if you've learned that already. Hopefully you have. X equals negative b, or the opposite of b, plus or minus the square root b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. I, however, have made a problem that I know factors. So we're going to take that leading coefficient and that constant, and we're going to multiply them together. So 8 times 5 is equal to 40. We're going to be looking for factors of that product that add up to the middle term. Well, 2 times 20 is equal to 40, and 2 plus 20 is, when we add them, equal to 22, which is our middle term. So we're going to rewrite the middle term and rewrite this whole expression as a polynomial of 4 terms instead of a trinomial. With our two middle terms written with these coefficients, And then we're going to factor that by grouping. These first two terms share a common factor of 2x. 8x squared divided by 2x is 4x, and 2x divided by 2x is 1, so just plus 1. These two terms both share a common factor of 5, so we're going to divide that out. And you'll notice that we have a common factor within our two new terms, which is 4x minus 4x plus 1. So we're going to divide out or factor out that 4x plus 1 and write 4x plus 1 times 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. And then now that we have this in factored form, we're going to solve this equation by factoring. We just did a bunch of videos about factoring, did we not? So, wonder why that was. So, we have two factors being multiplied together to give us a function that's equal to 0. So, the only way to multiply and get an answer of 0 is if one of those factors are equal to 0. So, we have 4x plus 1 equals 0 and 2x plus 5 equals 0. We need to solve those out individually, and I'm starting to run out of room here. Didn't realize how much room this example was going to need. So let's just make some more room. We're going to take 4x minus 1 or plus 1, have it equal to 0. We're going to subtract both sides by 1, divide both sides by 4 and get negative 1, not negative 1 half. How about negative 1 fourth is one of our solutions. And take the 2x plus 5, set it equal to 0, subtract both sides by 5, divide both sides by 2, and that answer is negative 5 halves. Now it's very, very important with rational equations that you take these answers and you plug them back into the original problem and make sure they work. For one, that's always a good practice to make sure that your answers are indeed correct. And with rational equations, you have a good chance of something becoming dividing by zero. You don't want one of your solutions to allow your original equation to have a division of zero in it somewhere. So you want to make sure you plug these back into your original problem and make sure that both sides are actually equal. That's really not going to be an issue with this problem because we don't have a variable in a denominator, so it's not possible for any of our solutions to make either one of those denominators equal to zero. And let me just make sure I did not make a mistake. Good. I've got the same answers that I have in my notes. Let's get to the other problem here. I'm going to need to erase these, so make sure you get those down. Okay. For this example over here, we only have one fraction on the left-hand side and one fraction on the right, so we could solve this with cross-multiplication. And the step I'm going to show, which is multiplying both sides by the lowest common multiple, is going to achieve the same thing in about the same amount of time. I just want you to know, one fraction equal to one fraction, cross-multiplication is a valid method of solving that equation. We, just to be consistent, are going to multiply the entire equation. I'm going to show this a little bit different than the other one. I'm just going to show one huge parenthesis around the entire equation. And we're going to multiply by 12. Why 12? Because 12 is divided by 12, so it's going to cancel out that denominator. And 12 is divisible by 4, so it's going to cancel that denominator out as well. A fraction bar is one big grouping symbol, right? It's just, it says, take all of this on top and divide it by what's in the denominator. So we have one term on the left, like I just said, one term on the right, so we're going to do this distributive property and only have to do it twice because there's only two terms. So all of this is divided by 12. I'm multiplying by 12, so it's going to cancel out completely and get x times x plus 13. Over on the right-hand side, 12 divided by 4 is 3, so we have 3 times x plus 8. We're going to distribute through these parentheses and get x squared plus 13x equals 3x plus 24. We have a squared term and a single degree term, so it's not going to be possible to get this equation where you just have x equals a number and that's it. So we're going to have to get this equation equal to 0 and then either factor or use the quadratic formula. This one will be factorable as well. We're going to bring this 3x over with subtraction. I guess I probably should be showing that, so let's do this. We're going to do minus 3x from both sides and get x squared plus 10x equals 24. Bring the 24 over the same. It's a positive 24, so we're going to subtract 24 from both sides. Now we have a quadratic with a leading coefficient of 1, so those, if factorable, are quite easy to do so. Factors of 24 that subtract to be 10. Positive 12 times negative 2 is negative 24, and positive 12 minus 2 is equal to 10. So those are the factors that we want. We get factors of the first term and the first two blank. Factors of the last term is the one we want. Are positive 12 and negative 2 in the last two blanks. We have two factors being multiplied together to give us 0, so each one of those, or one of those, needs to be 0. So x plus 12 is equal to 0, and x minus 2 is equal to 0. Both of these, you know, can't be true at the same time, but if either one of them are true, then we are multiplying by 0, and thus we will get 0, and it is a solution. So subtract both sides by 12, we get negative x equals negative 12. That's one solution. Add 2 to both sides, and we get x equals positive 2. That is the other solution. When we plug those values in, either the negative 12 everywhere there's an x, or the positive 2 everywhere there's an x, we will be getting, you know, two sides of the equation that are equal. I got one more example. Bam! Here is our last example. X over 4 minus x minus 3 over 2 greater than or equal to 2x plus 1 over 5 minus 1. Except for the fact this has 4 terms instead of, you know, 2 or 3 like the other examples, the only real difference, and it's kind of a big one, is we have an inequality in the middle somewhere, not an equal sign. The steps for solving this is exactly the same is solving an equation. The only difference, as by now I hope you know, is when you multiply both sides of the inequality by a negative number, or you divide both sides of the inequality by a negative number, you have to change the direction of the inequality. So let's get going. We're going to look at our denominators. We have 4, 2, and 5. I like to take the biggest number, take one of the numbers, and start running through the multiples of that number until you recognize one where all of those values will go into it. So let's take 5, okay? 5, 10, 2 goes into 10, but not 4, 15, 20. Okay, so 20 divided by 4 is 5, 20 divided by 2 is 10, and 20 divided by 5 is equal to 4. So if I multiply everything by 20, the lowest common multiple, I will cancel out all those fractional coefficients and make my life a little bit easier. So we're going to do that. So we're going to multiply these two terms by 20. We're going to multiply these two terms by 20. That's a positive 20, so I don't need to worry about changing the direction of the inequality. And instead of showing quite so many steps, I'm going to try and do this in my head a little bit, okay? So hopefully keep up. 20 divided by 4, because this is for you, not me. 20 divided by 4, that's equal to 5. So 5x. Now I'm going to keep this minus here. 20 divided by 2 is equal to 10. So negative 10, and because it's negative, I'm going to keep these parentheses in here. So negative 10, that's the 20 divided by 2, and there's the minus sign, times x minus 3 is greater than or equal to 20 divided by 5 is 4. And I think I'm going to go ahead and just keep these parentheses for the binomials in here. 2x plus 1, and then minus, not 1, but 20 times negative 1 is negative 20. Now let's distribute through those parentheses. Make sure you do take care of that sign as you do that. So we have 5x minus 10x plus 30 is greater than or equal to 8x plus 4 minus 20. Okay, we have, oh, for a change, we don't have a second degree equation here, so we are going to be able to just get x by itself. So we're going to add like terms. We have 5 minus 10, which is negative 5x. And we have 4 minus 20, which is negative 16. Now I have a variable, an x, on both the left and right hand side. If I add both sides by 5x, that's fine. And I'm not going to have to worry about changing the direction of the inequality, but I do see students make more mistakes when they move their variables to the right hand side. Not that that's an incorrect step, but it's the type of mistakes I see. I see more mistakes when students move their variables to the right as opposed to when they move them to the left. So even though I'm going to have to change the direction of this inequality here in another step coming up, I am going to go ahead and subtract both sides by 8x and move my variable to the left. So negative 5 and negative 8 is negative 13, plus 30 is greater than or equal to negative 16. I'm going to subtract both sides by 30. And that will give us negative 13x is greater than or equal to, that would be negative 46. Okay, so now I got negative 13x is greater than or equal to negative 46. I need to, you know, solve for x, so I'm going to move or undo that multiplication of negative 13 by dividing. I'm going to divide by negative 13. This is going to cancel out, and we do have x. We are dividing by that negative number, so we are going to need to change the direction of that inequality. So now it's less than or equal to, and not much is going to happen here if you're keeping your answers in exact format. The negatives are just simply going to cancel out. So we have 46 divided by 13, and that's our answer. And that means I'm done. So I'm Mr. True. Go do your homework.